Hi, it's David K. Welcome to Lake Minnetonka today.
I'm at the boat landing on Gray's Bay on fishing opening. And yeah, there's some activity out here. It's fishing opening on the night before Mother's Day. And there's boats and lake life is rocking. They're coming and going. And just remember, if you're out there fishing, that you ought to consider safety, you know, because the water is still cold. You've got to worry about your hypothermia. I would say people ought to make sure they wear life vests or have one real dang close. Yeah, there's a bit of a traffic here. Used to be a little marina here where you could just, you know, go up, grab candy, and the neighbors would come down, and guy had a little store, and you know, it was a all around this lake there were little fun, unique little things that don't exist anymore, like that Gray's Bay Marina, and little pubs and little crazy little off the beaten path little places. Well, we're gonna drive around the lake today on Lake Minnetonka today, the brand new cable show on Metro Cable Network 6, MCN-6, and we'll see what we find. So what do you do on a Saturday morning? Go get your coffee, you can't go inside, you sit in line at the Caribou, 7-101. Maybe you go shopping at Target. There's some stuff going on at Target, Lake Minnetonka today. Yes, today, there are people shopping at Target. Moms biking, pulling their kids. Yes, some people wearing masks, some not. Supply chain stuff going on over here. Absolutely activity over here at Target. Uh-huh. You can get your tires fixed today. Lake Minnetonka. Wendy's a bit slow. Where's the beef? Short of beef. One of my favorite things to do is smoke my little Dominican Cohiba cigars, and I get them right here at the cigar lounge. These rocking. There's some landscaping going on. How many of these guys are wearing masks? Let's just check it out, just for fun. Zero. Oh, one. Nope. I don't know. Whatever. I'm trying to make a statement. About 11, fishing opener, day before Mother's Day, and then we'll just see what's the kind of fun lake life is going on. Lake Minnetonka, Excelsior Bay. Yes, we're on the 2nd Street exit off of Highway 7 heading into Excelsior. We're hands-free filming. I've got my, camera set up facing forward, and we're just going to go wander around Excelsior here. See what Lake Minnetonka today. What's going on Lake Minnetonka today? If you take a right off that exit, you go just a little bet and you see Maynards. They've got some sort of drop-off pickup going on. There's a guy walking without a mask. There's two gals walking without a mask. That's three. Let's just do a little check. And we'll do a little turnaround. We're right crossing the trail here. Here's some bikers. What a beautiful day to go biking. One, two, three, four without masks. Okay, so that's five people without masks. Look at, you can drive into McDonald's. A lot of activity at McDonald's. Drive-ups are rocking. Oh, Adele's. Adele's is a yogurt shop that's just super favorite place. Lots of people at Adele's. Here's a good place to turn around. Yeah, I could stop by Adele's. This is a beautiful little town, Excelsior. About 3,000 people. A little less, I believe. And one of the half a dozen major commercial little districts with a beautiful little main street. And we're back at the trail. About where the trail is, there's another biker. There's two moms, no masks. Biker, no mask. What was that? Eight? Eight with no masks. There's a lady walking right now on the phone. Nine with no masks. Just curious about it. I mean, you can stay 6 feet away from people walking or biking for sure. That's safe without a mask. It's just, kind of curious. Beautiful. Excelsior's Men's Garden Club already out there kind of keeping their beautiful little areas clean, getting ready to plant, I'm sure, but it's cold out, so about this time, this week, we're having some chill. Where was I at? Was I at 9 or 11? I don't know. I'll just count them because we can have, there's two more without masks. There's a lady without a mask. I've only seen one mask. Two dudes sitting. There's Rob Nash. Hey, Rob. Sitting out in the yard. There's some people sitting on picnic tables. Let's go to Main Street. Then we'll go to the Commons. No mask, no mask, no mask, no mask, no mask. Dunn Brothers. Open. Look at these big signs on the windows. Takeout at the Lagos Tacos. Little gift shops open for, curbside. And that's good. Curbside. Takeout at Coalition, which is also owned, same guys own Red Sauce Rebellion right here. Curbside right here at Amore Fede. Yeah, there's people out. I mean, it looks kind of like a normal day. It's just, of course, a little tougher to do the curbside. I suppose you have people come in your store. But they're trying to rock their businesses, which is good, right? Let's go check the Commons. Celsius Commons. Let's go down here. 3rd Street. Suburban. Is online orders available at the Suburban? interesting.
We got some charter cruise boats in, which are not yet allowed to sail with the Olympic groups, etc. Tom's talking trolley. Is he open yet? Can't tell. Some activity at the pier. Let's see if Kowalski's is as busy as Target.
Yeah,
we're rocking. Kowalski's is doing some business. Minnetonka Bay, near Excelsior. This whole end is going to be torn down, so it'll kind of curve right around here, and then there'll be some apartments over here. So yeah, so Sanctuary moved from over there down there. Wow, that's news, you know. So that's gonna happen. I don't love the plan, how it looks. I had some more creative ideas, but who listens to me? Thanks, Bob, for holding the camera.
No.
But there's some activity over here at Bay to Bay Boat Club. It's down by a little boat landing down here on Lakeview Avenue off of Minnetonka Bay. There's some activity, some boats out here. This little boat landing isn't super busy, but there's not much parking down here. Caribbean was purchased by some new people, but Marina and Shakopee. That's a big island over there. Lund's Barley is 15 and 19, County Road 15 and 19. Oh, rocking. Lots of activity right here. Fishing opener. And you got the custom rods and tackles, but you got these kind of fishing just parking on the sidewalk. So thanks again, Bob, for holding the camera. A little less busy over here at Spring Park. Yes, help us fight invasive species. Remove your weeds, drain your water, compost, recycle, etc., etc. You can get your curbside takeout. Go to the gym. One nice little success story in this world today. The Minnetonka drive-in. Old school, 1950s. Pull your car up, get yourself a hot dog and a burger. So look at this parking lot across the street. There's a brewery right over there, back channel brewery. Giant parking lot. Not really being utilized. Imagine a little drive-in theater right here by the drive-in. Just a thought, but all manner of rules and regulations. But anyways, stop by the drive-in. Beautiful mound, Lost Lake Channel. Little boating activity, boats and slips.
Surfside Park Mound. Old mining on Cox Bay. Some activity. Not as busy, some empty spaces.
Decent stop at Bay Rentals. Grab some ice cream. Mound Jubilee and the Harbor Wine and Spirits. Pretty busy in Mound. Scotty B's open for must be curbside. I'm not sure if Carboni is. Some activity up here.
Lake Minnetonka today. Big fish, little fish. Some survive, some don't.
Harrison's Bay, where it meets Seton Channel, Metro Lakes Marina. Pontoon rentals. They've got bait. Right off of County Road 15, Mound, Minnesota.
Some activity at your boat club. Life going on over here. They've torn up, was that a Main Street? All the way down to the railroad tracks. Down about the boat works, it looks like it's one way going towards the tracks. But anyway, it's kind of a big deal. Better time to do it than another time in history though. This is new, grocer's table. Market Cafe and Wine Bar on Broadway. So Lake Minnetonka, western suburbs, 14 towns touch a lake that has many channels, islands, peninsulas, a lot of commercial districts to boat off and kind of dock up and maybe dine, cocktail, places to drop anchor and party. It's just a little different this year. So Sheriff's Water Patrol and the Lake Minnetonka Conservation District, the governing body of the lake, are asking people to social distance. Don't tie up your boats. Just boat with household members, people you've been with in the family. We gotta try to adhere and not spread the virus. It looks like Governor Waltz is opening up restaurants June 1st. Right now, retail just was open to 50% capacity. We'll see how all this works, but we all just need to look out for each other. It's going to be a tough, unique situation to deal with as a business person, as a resident, as a lake-loving, lake-life person. But let's just all work it out, you know. We hope the numbers don't spike and more people get sick and die. Let's just try to live the best, safe, shared lake life that we can. If you'd like to have us feature you on this show, stop by, shoot some casual video of your business. Just email me, Dave at lakeguy.com. and we'll figure something out. If you'd like to advertise in the Lake Minnetonka Navigator magazine or our sister publication, same, email me, dave@lakeeye.com. We publish monthly, tons of free pickup locations. We've been doing it 23 years. Our laminated map, which we've been showing in this show, to give you an orientation as to some of the places we've been, will be delivered shortly. It's pretty much sold out, but if you catch us quick and you want to get a business card on the backside, there's thousands of maps. Thousands of returning snowbirds have gotten back from Palm Springs, Naples, wherever they go. And they're going to live this lake life, so maybe you want to promote your business to them. And if you'd like to have a combo, be on the magazine, have a story done about your business, have us feature you on this show, we can do that. MCN Metro Cable Network, no, it's called Minnesota Community Network, sorry. Channel 6, that's on all of the Metro 7 County 14 cable network providers. And there's a Roku channel too, so a lot of ways to see us. You could reach hundreds of thousands of people. Email me, dave@lakeguy.com, and we'll work something out. Be safe out there, okay? Take care.